Spindle with a question for Ms. Custer.
Ms. Custer, is abortion a big deal in this race?
I think it is, in the sense that I believe in less government interference in people's personal lives. I think it's a private and personal decision, and women's access to reproductive health is something that they should make that decision. I've been an adoption attorney for 25 years, and so I'm certainly not pro-abortion in any way. I believe in a no-judgment zone, that it's a private matter for a woman, but I don't think it's for the government to decide. I was very surprised that Congressman Bass took a number of positions that are against the interests of women here in New Hampshire, not the least of which is a bill that, with the regrettable title, Let Women Die. And the reason is that a woman seeks emergency care during a pregnancy, the hospital can deny that care, and Congressman Bass apparently supports that position. In northern New Hampshire, when you've driven an hour and a half through the woods and in a snowstorm, you don't have an alternative if you finally make it to the emergency room and if you're in emergent condition. He's voted against family planning. He's voted in the Ryan budget to deep cuts in family planning that will close access. He's voted to allow insurance companies to restrict access to birth control. So these are all important issues. I'll be a strong advocate for the women in New Hampshire.
Well, Congressman, you call yourself pro-choice. There's a number of things there.
I support Roe v. Wade. I voted for Title X funding. I'm as strong an advocate for a woman's right to choose as anybody here standing on the podium tonight. And above and beyond that, I supported and have worked hard to make sure that the Violence Against Women's Act is reauthorized in the form that's best for providing those services. And I don't know what Annie's talking about all these other votes, but I suspect that they are all kind of a prestidigitation into the budget somehow. Budgets don't set appropriations levels or set policy. They're blueprints that other committees use to enact legislation and reconciliation. And when the Democrats said that voting against the Ryan budget would be the core of their campaign, they weren't kidding. And they sent Annie Custer every single talking point that she's used in this campaign and tied everything to the Ryan budget or the House Republican budget. There's more to this than that. We need to stop this bickering, this partisanship, this gotcha kind of debate, and start talking about working together on a debt and deficit reduction budget that will really work, that's supported by both Republicans and Democrats. And my opponent characterizes that budget as pitiful.
I don't think it would come as a surprise to either of you that there's a number of